Hello friends, how are you doing? It's Ilze Be with my weekly video lesson on Latvian language and traditions. And today I will focus on one word and I will teach you two Latvian sayings where that word is used. And at the end of this video, I'll tell you about one thing that you shouldn't do when you are in Latvia if you are a man. If you are a woman, that's all right. Us women, we are a little privileged. So let's dive straight in, and I hope you'll enjoy my lesson. All right, so the focus word for today's class that I have chosen is cepure. Cepure. And cepure means this. Yes, it's a hat. But before we start with the sayings, I want to explain you something. And that is that the word cepure does not always appear as I showed it to you. It can have various different forms. So, and these are the possible endings of the word cepure. First, the base form is cepure. But it can also be cepures or cepurei. I'll pronounce this one again, cepurei. Or it can be cepuri or cepure. I'll pronounce this one again, cepure or cepuru. Or cepurem or cepures. So you see, there can be 8 different versions of that word, and I teach all about when to use which version in my course Latvian for English Speakers, which is a sponsor of this free video. But now let's get to the first saying. So Latvian saying number one that I chose to explain to you is neskati vīru no cepures. And you see that the ending of the word cepure here has changed. I'll read the saying again. Neskati vīru no cepures. And what this means literally is, don't judge a man by his hat. But how do we say this in English? We say, don't judge a book by its cover. So this is a Latvian version of don't judge a book by its cover, and I'll read it one more time. Neskati vīru no cepures. And another saying that I'd like to tell you today is dzīvo cepures. Cepuri kuldams. Dzīvo cepuri kuldams. And here you see that the ending is I. What it literally means is he or she or they. I think most often it's used when talking about a man. He lives beating his hat. Beating his hat, what does it mean? It means he lives worryless. I think the explanation of this is that a man doesn't have to work at all or too much in order to survive or to live happily, and so he can worrylessly tap rhythm on his hat. That's my explanation. I really don't know the origin of this saying, but everyone in Latvia knows its meaning. I'll read it again. Dzīvo cep. And finally, I would like to give you one good advice what not to do in Latvia if you are a man or a boy. So, this is a picture that I took in the United States. I think it was the first year when I started living here permanently, and I took it because it surprised me. And this is what I don't want you to do if you are in Latvia, because it is considered very impolite for a man to sit by the table wearing a hat. I think this might not be just Latvian tradition. It might be the same in other European countries, just it's not a big deal here in the United States, but in Latvia it's a no-no. All right, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed my lesson. If you would like to download this presentation about cepure, please click the link in the description of this video. If you like my lessons, check out my website and subscribe to my emails, because sometimes I send good advice about Latvian language and culture via emails. But now I'll say bye-bye, atā, till the next time.